weight and drag. Bringing the rudder on the side of the normal PEX design, that helps reach in terms of your control, and in combination with the wing configuration, further improves roll rate.
Thank you. This course, has so recently announced the purchase of 32 AW149s. Their missions in Polish service will include transport, their support, as well as the counter-air, search and rescue roles, and general transport. He said these are the occasions where he's shot down. So named because the aircraft is in effect describing the outline of an imaginary barrel in the sky. Fast now.
To our hopes, nowadays we have a HUD display in our hopes, and also we have done some upgrades for the cockpit instruments also, so we have a digital instrument there, and so the situation awareness is much better, and also some other small, not smaller, but project also, like a simulated radar warning receivers. So it keeps you to for the training.
They would have supported an armed advance across the North German plain into Western Europe, the sphere of influence as well. And what we see here in the Mine 171. Thank you. a new task and forced landing at Fairport.
Yuri, good copy. Break free. C-130, these are the Austrian Typhoons. Recognize the aircraft on your right wing. You are to land at Fairport.
Scampton will close at the end of this year and the team will move to RAF Warrington. In tribute to Scampton, its squadron and its history, and now that the 617 fly the F-35, this is the Lightning Loop. Again, the team reaching 5,500 feet and at 150 miles per hour as they slow and accelerate back down to the ground. As the team turns to the left, on the far right hand side is Red 4, squad leader John Bond, known as Bondy. Bondy is in his fifth year on the team, having been the synchro leader last year, and he is also a half one. He now smokes blue. Looking to the right hand side, you'll see Enid forming an inverted V. As Red 6 and 7 line up.
Soviet of John Doe is concocted as a ruse to escape enemy fire. The Doe will be close to them by a slow path turn on our left.
Traps the undercarriage, waiting for it to show up, 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 lights out before engaging the readings. Speed pass, 100 feet, 600 miles an hour before breaking into another 9G half horizontal. Thank you.
point, a similar specification was given to all the civil aviation, but Kingston upon Thames, and to feed potential configuration.
Spanish.
suffered the highest loss ratio of any recorded combat in all 5,573 men were killed in bomber combat. The flight attendants. Was the last ever Hurricane Bird rolled off the dust and landed in July 1960. Inscriptive of the words, last of the many, which we still keep as the multitude of painted scenes. In 1950, the end of the King's Cup Air Race was in second place, flown by good Captain Townsend. And then during the 1960s, she was flown by the famous Bill Bedford, OBE, ASU, and appeared in the Battle of Britain film. We have two aircraft today. That was the back of Winston. He says, currently appears to the all black night fighter cover scheme, representing Hurricane Mark 2, 3, 2, 3, 4.
Well, as I mentioned, he's been certainly displaying for 50 years now. His early displays were in the Royal Air Force Hunter, and he displayed in the very first international air school at North Korea in 1972, so well in his 50th year. But displaying civil aircraft such as this since 1984, that's not a bad line, is it?
But we're coming back.
So, before the Grand Prix came into service, this is the aircraft that most pilots across all three services would have been used to do their initial selection on. Now the contract is differently and we don't have...
On the far right hand side, what a moment to look at! There's a course from the Lombard. Don't have fun with the smoke of Brad Stick. Red Stone in flight attendant James Turner. He's the infinity symbol in the sky for the infinity frame. He's born in an absolute pleasure to perform these days. Please, put your hands together for the 2022 Royal Air Force Aerobatics team.
With the red arrows. this is a personal favourite of mine and also a great social opportunity.
Okay.
James will now accelerate down the line in the red arrow. He's building energy here. He pulls straight up into a series of vertical rows. At the top, he will attempt to stop and let the aircraft twist itself under the engine. This is known as a torque roll. And then he lets the aircraft fall backwards through the throat into a tailslide. Here it is now. Aerobyte specializes in delivering aviation safety software, providing solutions to over 200 airlines globally.
Thank you.
Thank you.
conductor. But a lot of them have a victory though, run an amazing restoration company. Of course, that's a lot of maintenance work, but also the performance down the line there, cars through the film, and other cars. Very notably, let's just say that it remains a friend of many today. We should. Thank you. Belgium and Holland engaged on active service with 16 squadron. And it's participated right up until the end of the war in Operation Crossroads to detect D1 and D2 vengeance weapon launch sites. So, been there right at the start then.
Associate the Curtiss P-40 design with the noise of the Merlin engine, but that's exactly the combination we have here in Europe's only airworthy example of the P-40F model. It was generally the Allison V-1710 that powered the P-40 family of fighters. Aircraft, that of one that was flown in the Italian theatre by the US Army Air Forces during 1944, and now one of the most distinctive American fighters in the world, the Corsair.
This Corsair is painted in the colours of a British fleet aircraft of 1850 Squadron, round about December 1945, when they were embarked.
Airplane. Rommel had built various biplane fighters in the 1930s for the US Navy, and they conceived a new product, the F-4F, as a biplane. But at the same time, a rival manufacturer, Brewster, was developing a new monoplane fighter called the F-2A.
And was acquired eventually by the Fighter Collection in 1993.
pilots, under the direction of the Patrouille Suisse commander, Lieutenant Colonel Nils Hemmerle, will present to you the highest level of aeronautical precision at speeds of almost 550 knots and unique teamwork. Pure Swissness, high in the air above Duxford, please give a warm welcome to the Patrouille Suisse.
Thank you.